In 1976, the very year I was born, another thing came to fruition in Australia, a tiny little film from South Australia called Storm Boy, which went on to become a rite of passage for a whole generation of Australians, including me, and become perhaps the nation's most loved and iconic motion picture. And now, in what is the most ambitious target in recent history, it has been remade in an incredible new version. We've got all the stars of that here to talk to, but before we do that, let's have a bit of a look at it.
It was called 90 Mile Beach. I was cut off from the world. Then one day the world came to me.
Look!
They're too young. There's nothing we can do.
They won't die. It worked.
You keep feeding them.
I grow up to be big and strong.
It's amazing.
He's a good boy.
All right, Mr. Percival, go find him.
I can tell you, it really packs a punch. Please welcome Jai Courtney, Trevor Jamieson, and the breakout star of the film, Finn Little. Jai, we'll start with you. I saw this film a couple of days ago and it really just, it punches you in all the vital organs. It's really such a dramatic, I mean, you know, you're crying, I don't know what became it. I mean, look, it's no Die Hard 5, but it's close. Yeah. Did you grow up with the original Storm Boy and were you worried about recreating such a, well, remaking such
I grew up with it. I wasn't worried. I think it's like, you know, when you approach something like this, you always have to come in with a level of respect and, you know, you have to investigate whether the creative team are going to, you know, honour it and honour the legacy that this, you know, this piece of literature and the original film have. It is obviously such a cultural icon for us. So, you know, we had to know we were going to serve that. And Justin Monjo wrote a beautiful script. When I was asked to come aboard, it was a total no-brainer. I couldn't, you know, jump quick
and
enough.
And it's probably worth mentioning, it's not just a remake of it. It's sort of flipping it a bit and it plays with it a bit.
Yeah,
as well,
there's a contemporary thread which kind of reimagines the story in kind of retrospect, and we're sort of swept back into that main narrative that we know to be the original story of Storm Boy.
Indeed. And Trevor, you play Fingerbone Bill, who was originally played by David Gulpilil, of course, who now plays your father in the film. What was it like working with him and what's that whole experience been like?
Well, this is the second time I've worked with him, you know. Every time he's in front of the camera, just like Finn, you know, he actually commands the camera. So it was just... well, you know, I was in awe, basically. When I was a kid, I've always wanted to idol myself. Well, you know, he was my idol. I tried to model myself like David. He's just amazing. He's one of our, you know, national treasures. So,
100%.
Yeah, years before with STC, we did the stage play, so that gave me a lot of excitement to be playing this role. And now, given the opportunity to play Fingerbone again, but this time, you know,
on the screen.
Yeah, on the big screen, so I'm really chuffed, yeah.
How good.
And Finn, you were just, you're just 12 years old, is that right?
Yes, 12 years.
How do kids actually act? Because my kids don't know anything. Like, did you even see the original film?
Yes, I did see the original film before I went to shoot it. Yeah, it's such an iconic Australian film.
How did they pick you? Did you have to audition? Was there like a nationwide search?
Yeah, there was a nationwide search for Storm Boy, yeah.
And why did you put your hand up for it?
Well, you know, it's a massive opportunity. You're not just going to throw it away.
Did you feel a real connection with the part? Was there anything about the character that you really identified with?
I just love how caring he is for the birds, you know. We had some great birds on set and great trainers, and everyone who worked on that film really put their heart and soul into it. And, you know, the director, Sean Seat, did an amazing job with it, and just everyone came together and we made such an amazing film.
Was it hard working with pelicans? Because, I mean, it's hard enough working with people.
they do misbehave sometimes, but they are beautiful. They're beautiful birds, yeah.
What did they do? What was the toughest bit?
When they don't have fish, they get cranky.
Really?
Yes. Okay. Yeah. I've heard of actors who don't get enough craft services who get cranky.
We're going to be snappy when there's no fish around.
When there's no fish around.
You don't get an actor who's sushi. That's it.
It's a walk-off.
Jai, working at home for you, you've been in all these huge Hollywood blockbusters. The last few times I've caught up with you has always been over there or Berlin or wherever we've been. What was it like for you to work in it? You know, it couldn't be a more Australian.
It's always so special to come home and to work on something and to come home and do, you know, be a part of something so iconic and so beloved by Aussies, you know, across multiple generations was a real treat. And we had a ball, man. You know, it's a beautiful, beautiful story. It was my first kind of foray into playing, a father, really.
Yeah.
Mm. I've had, you know, that's sort of danced that a little bit, but not really where in a role where I get to investigate that relationship. And it really is, you know, we built, you know, a lot of trust between us, Finn and I, and we knew we had to bring the best out in each other.
And it's incredibly, I mean, yours, I think, is the most complex role in the film because you say so little and have to communicate so much.
Yeah.
What was harder? Was it working with Bruce Willis, Arnold Schwarzenegger, or Mr. Percival?
You'd be surprised.
I imagine Bruce, you know, if he doesn't get his sushi,
he gets a bit snappy. Yeah, indeed.
We also have to ask, obviously, the film stars Jeffrey Rush. Without going into any detail, there's been some legal issues, a court case, some controversy. Has that been difficult in the making or the marketing? Has that been a distraction for you or has that affected the making of the film?
I think it's something that, you know, we just have to take into consideration. And look, the three of us are here. We're proud. We're in front of the film and we know we've made a beautiful piece of cinema. And, you know, that's what we're here to promote and that's the message we're going to push.
Do you worry that the people might stay away and the film might not get there?
I don't think people will. I mean, look, whatever's happening in, you know, Jeffrey's personal life is one thing, but it's completely independent of, you know, this story and the story we've told. And, you know, I think audiences who grew up with it will come and see it again and also it'll, you know, breathe new life into it for a new generation.
I studied it at school. Did you guys study it at school?
Yes, yeah, I did. Yeah.
And Finn, is it still on the school syllabus?
I didn't study it, but people in other classes did, yeah.
Okay. So there is that reason to get out there and see it.
Yeah. I just remember it being mandatory.
Yeah,
I just remember, like, it feels like every single kid said, right, you know, you watch Storm Boy, you follow the footy, and then if there's time, you know, you can learn to read and write. Trevor, what would you like audiences to take home from this film?
Oh, well, really, it's a show about, you know, family values, spending quality time. But not only that, it's a timeless piece. And Colin Tilley, you know, we talk about him a lot.
That's right.
And, the story is about five characters. So, I mean, there's four. There's myself as Fingerbone Bill, Jai as Hideaway Tom, you know, Finn, Storm Boy, and Mr. Percival. But there's also the Coorong, the land, you know. So we get to promote and show people, a beautiful part of South Australia.
It is incredibly beautiful and so immaculately shot. And I love how all the characters have sort of nicknames like Hideaway Tom. They used to call me Go Away Joe. Finn, you're about to be a huge star. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Have you got a list of demands? Like no brown M&Ms?
Okay, so first of all, I need my M&Ms colour coordinated in my trailer on exact time.
Oh, I like this kid already. You are going to go very far in television, mate.
And his water at room temperature, I believe.
That's right. I said Evian. A Storm Boy opens around the country next Thursday. It's an extraordinary film. Go and take a look at it. Thank you very much, Jai, Finn, and Trevor.